Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I am going to create an Azure function using Visual Studio and then I will deploy it to Azure Cloud and then invoke it from within Azure portal and also from the browser. I'll also show you how to run it locally and invoke the Azure function. So that's the purpose of this video. Please like my video and also subscribe to this channel so that I can come up with more such videos. So let's get started. So I have opened Visual Studio 2022 here. So you just click on create a new project. And here you can search for Azure Function. So search for functions. So you can see Azure Function has come up. Since I selected it earlier, that's why it is coming up here. But yeah, you can just type it here and then select it, then click next. Here we'll just give a name to our project. So whatever name you give, that will become your namespace. So give a good meaningful name. For example, I will say demo function. Okay, and then click create. Now in this window, so you can see it is latest framework .NET 6 is selected here, .NET 6 core. And then the type we'll select here is HTTP trigger so that we can invoke this function through a HTTP call. Okay, so which means we can use our browser and then just call this function. Here select anonymous so that we can anyone can call this function. So this that will do for this particular video. Azure will also create a storage account, so ensure if you want to deploy it to Azure, just ensure that you have a storage account and you also have a Azure subscription, and you and Azure will also create a storage account, so ensure that you have some credit in your account, free credit. And after the demo, after you have practiced it, you can delete the resource groups etc. from Azure so that it doesn't incur any cost to your subscription. So for this we'll keep it like this. Okay, and then hit the create button, so it will create some code by default for you. So I will go through the code and then tell you what it is. So for example, as I said, the name of the, so we have given it as demo function, right? So that is the name of the function app, and that will be, that has also become the name of the demo function. Now a function app can contain multiple Azure functions. Okay, it is a logical grouping of the Azure functions. So each function can have its own logic and you can deploy it, and it will have its own kind of if it is a HTTP trigger, then it will have its own endpoint. So you can then call this endpoint from other code or directly from the browser also. So here you can see a static class is created. So if we want, we can rename this also. Okay, or we can keep it as it is, like function one, and this is the function name. And you can change the function name if you want. The entry point is the run method. Okay, it is an asynchronous method. And it has, as you can see, now the authorization level is anonymous, which we have provided when we created this function app, and it can accept both GET and POST. So similarly, it has parameters here, which is a HTTP request object, and another is iLogger object. That is, this iLogger is used for this logging information. So you can use this log object to log any information, and the HTTP request object is used to read the request, okay, which comes to this function, and then when you read this request, you can then retrieve the data that has come as part of the request. So that is about this function name and the parameters, and then there is a default code here which is very simple. So so this line basically reads the query string. So from the query string, it will search for a property called as name. You can, if you don't want to pass name or you want to pass something else, let's say address, or you want to pass a city name, you can do that. And then here, instead of name, we can read the city. Okay, so and then you have this so another line of code here, which basically reads the body of the request. Okay, and then it deserializes it, and then you can see there is some code which will then try to find a name property in that body, and accordingly it will display the name here, okay, in the response object. So what we'll do, we'll run it, and you will see that when we run it, so we will run it without passing the name parameter. In that case, you can see here this ternary expression, which will basically, since we are not passing any name, so it will display the first part here, okay, which will say this HTTP trigger function executed successfully. That will be displayed, and if we pass a name, then the name will be displayed. Okay, so in that case, this message will not be displayed, but this second message will be displayed. All right, so let's now go ahead and run this. So first, let's build this. So the build has started. You can see the status here, and now it is succeeded. Just hit the run button. Okay, now it is trying to run the function app, and then we have got the URL. So what you need to do is you have to copy this URL. So I have just selected it, and then I'm use Control C and go to your browser and just type it here. Okay, you can see the first part is now visible. This HTTP trigger function executed successfully. Pass a name in the query string or in the request body for a personalized response. So if you go here, you can see this is the first part. Okay, the HTTP triggered function executed successfully. That is what I was talking about earlier. So now what we will do is we'll pass a name. Okay, and then if it executes correctly, then this part should be displayed instead of the first message. Okay, the second message should get displayed. To pass the name, what you have to do is now, so this is important that the path is api/function1. Okay, so what we will now do is add a question mark, name equal to, I will say, let's say Scott. Okay, if I hit here, now you can see hello Scott. So that message got displayed, right? So this is, now it is the second message which is getting displayed. So that is how you run a Azure function. Okay, next we'll do some we can actually do something more also here. Like, for example, instead of name, I will say city. Okay, and I will again run it. So I just so now instead of name, I should get the city, but the problem is that now it is written name. Okay, no, it will work correctly. There is no need to make any changes. So it will just read the city name. Okay, so the parameter is now city instead of name. So we'll just run it. So it is again building it because I have changed the code. Okay, now we have it. So the function is running. What we will do is we'll go back here. Now if you hit it again, let's see what happens. Okay, now it is not finding name. That's why the first message again it's getting displayed, the default message. Okay, so let's change this to city. Okay, this parameter name, let's say city is London. Okay, now you can see the moment I hit enter now, so the message got changed. Hello London. Okay, so that is the second message that is getting displayed. So that is basically how this function is function works. So you can add your own business logic, and you can execute it on the cloud. So basically the intention here is that there is no need for you to basically worry about the computing or the storage or anything like that. So Azure will take care of everything. So it is called a serverless computing. So you don't worry about the server, the infrastructure. So everything will be taken care of by Azure. We just write the function, which will do which will have some business logic and do some specific work, and then deploy that function, Azure function, to the cloud. Okay, so that is why this are very useful. You can use these Azure functions to make API calls or to make database calls also, or to interact with any third parties. So that is a good. It can work like a you know, thin business layer where you can have some business logic, and you don't want to have your own server or worry about all those things. So this is just ready to go kind of solution. All right. Now the next thing which we will do is we will now deploy it to cloud. So for that, let's publish it. So right click on this function name and then click on publish. I have Azure account. So you need to have Azure account in order to publish it. So in the next screen now here, select Azure Function App. And then here you can see my Azure account is coming up here on top right, and it is asking for the resource group. So I will click on this plus sign, and then I will provide all those details, okay, in the next window. So in the next window, now the name is coming up as some demo function like this. So resource group, let's give a proper resource group name, maybe okay, demo function RG is resource group, and we will then also give some name here for the storage. So I will say lowercase. Name is not available. Okay. Let's try demo test function storage. Okay, this is available. So demo test function storage, and leave it is default. All these things, and click on OK. So this got. We can also kind of give him a meaningful name here. Let's see if it is available or not. Demo function test. No, this is not available. Maybe test 1 2. Okay, so demo function test 1 2 is our function app name, resource group, Azure storage. All those names we have provided here. Let's click on create. So it may take some time. All right, so the resource group has been created, the function app has been created on Azure. Now we need to publish the Azure function code to this function app. Okay, so ensure that this run from package file is checked, and then click on finish. In the next screen it will ask us to publish it. You can verify if everything is correct. Okay, and then we will just hit the publish button. So now it is publishing. So it is publishing this Azure function, okay, to the function app. So now the Azure function has been deployed to the function app. We can verify it. So let's go here. So you can see this resource group has been created here, demo function resource group, and here the function app and the storage account has been created. Let's go inside the function app. Inside the function app, you can see this functions here. So click on that function, and so let's see. So perhaps it will get created. Right, so now inside functions you can see that a function one has been created. Okay, so this is our Azure function. So you can have multiple Azure functions inside this function app, demo function test 12. So this is our HTTP trigger function, Azure function, And if you go to code plus test, you can see the DLL, and also you can see the entry point. So it will be in JSON format. So here you can see the DLL is this, the demo function. Okay, script file bin slash. So here is the location of the DLL, which contains our code. And then the entry point is demo function dot function one dot run. So this is the entry point. If you go to the code, so you can see, so demo function is the namespace, then function one is the class name, and run is the entry point, which is our entry method. Okay, so that contains our logic. So that is, so Azure knows that this is where it has to go to run, execute this logic. Okay, so if you want to run it, we can run it from here. So let's do it, test run. And here we have to then select, let's say get, add a parameter. And I think the parameter we selected is city. So let's add. City, we'll say new New York. Okay, let's run it. So you can see hello New York, this HTTP trigger function executed successfully. So that is the 200 response, which is success, and this is what we were expecting, right? So the second message here should be shown there, so you can see that the second message is getting shown here. Okay, so this we have run from within the portal, so you can also run it from a browser because it is a HTTP triggered function. So similar to this, we can run it from the browser. So what you need to do is you need to copy this URL. So the URL is here, so copy this URL. So after publish, you will get this URL here. You can also go here to overview of the function app, and you can find the URL here. Okay, so either way, just copy the URL. Now if you hit it, you'll get a default message like this: your functions 4.0 app is up and running. So which means our function app is running, but within the function app, then we have the Azure function, right? Which the code, so this is the Azure function which we have written. Okay, now we want to invoke this function. So this we have not invoked yet from the browser. So what we will do is, now the path is this. Okay, so just copy this path and add it to the end of this URL. Okay, so then slash API slash function one, which is our class name, and then city equal to London. Okay, or we can say city equal to perhaps some other country, some other city name also we can give, let's say Dublin. Hit, and you can see hello Dublin. Okay, so there's the second message which is now invoked. So that's a quick demo of how you can create a basic Azure function and then deploy it to Azure and then invoke it. Hope you have liked this video. So please let me know if you have any suggestions in the comments below.